Namaste everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the session 11 of Java and Web, java.lang.object. In this video we will learn about object cloning in Java. Suppose in the heap we have this object whose reference is stored into the reference variable s in the stack. Now I want to start the object cloning on the address addr1 on the heap. The object cloning started and the new object has been created in the heap. The new object is a clone of the older object. The reference of the newly created cloned object of the older object has been stored into the reference variable s1 in the stack. These two different objects are clones of each other. They have different addresses and different hash codes. The class java.lang.object has a method whose name is clone. And the method clone is a protected native method of the class java.lang.object. Let's check the method definition of the method clone in the source code of java.lang.object. This is the method definition of the method clone. The method clone returns reference to an object and the method clone is also a native method. You can see here the method clone is a protected method. By using the method clone, we can clone an object. We can clone an object only if it is clonable. Then now the question is, what is clonable? To make an object clonable, its class must implement a marker interface called clonable. We already have discussed about the concept of marker interface. The link of that video is given in the video description below. Clonable interface is present in java.lang package. We have the java file new.java which contains two classes, the class student and the class use. The class student implements clonable. The interface clonable is a marker interface. Then we have the class use. Inside the method main of the class use, we have created an object of type student. Then by using the reference variable s, we are calling the method clone. The method clone, which was in the java.lang.object, gets inherited in all the classes in Java. So it also got inherited in the class student. That's why we can call the method clone by using the reference variable s. Since the method clone returns a reference of type object, you can see here the method clone returns a reference of type object. So here we need to typecast whatever is returned by the method clone to the expected class. That's why we typecasted whatever returned by the method clone into a student. And finally, we stored the reference of this cloned object into the reference variable s1 of type student, the method in which you are calling the method clone. In the definition of that method, you need to write these two words. You need to write here throws clone not supported exception. Because the method clone can throw an exception, clone not supported exception, and this is a checked exception. If you are not getting what the exception is, we will talk about the exception in the next session of Java and Web. And we will discuss about what is a checked exception and what is an unchecked exception. We have to call the method clone to get a clone of the object. Then typecast the reference returned by the method clone. We need to typecast here whatever is returned by the method clone. But default implementation of clone is protected as we have already seen. That's how since the method clone in the class student is protected, we cannot call the method clone in another class. So this code will throw a compile time error. Let me try this code practically. Open new.java and this is the same code as we have seen. Try to compile this code, java c new.java. The compiler throws an error, clone has protected access in object. But when the protected clone method gets inherited in the class student, then it can be used in the methods of the same class. First of all, the class student implements clonable. And here in the method main of the class student, we are creating an object of type student. And finally, we are cloning an object whose reference is stored into the reference variable s by using the method clone. It will create a new object in the heap whose address will be stored into the reference variable s1. And both will have different hash codes. Let me try this code practically. Open new.java. And this is the same code as we have seen. Let me execute this code, java c new.java. It compiles fine. Now run it, java student. It runs fine and printing the same output as we have seen on the slide. If you want objects of other classes to make clone of an object of the class student, then we must have to override clone method in the class student and make it public. Here in the class student, we are overriding the method clone and making it public. Inside the method clone, we are calling the method clone of the parent class of the class student. That is, we are calling the method clone of the class object. Since we are calling the method clone of the class object, so the overridden method clone should throw clone not supported exception. After that, in the class use, we can call the method clone on the reference variable s, because now the method clone in the class student is public. Let's try this code practically. Open new.java, and this is the same code as we have seen. Let me execute this code. Java C new.java. It compiles fine. Now run it. Java use. It runs fine and printing the output. So actually there are two types of cloning: deep cloning and shallow cloning. Till now, whatever we studied about cloning in this video is called deep cloning. But in the previous sessions of Java and web, we know that we can create an object, and whatever is stored into the reference variable S1 can be stored into the reference variable S2. We already have learned this concept in the previous sessions of Java and web. So creating a new reference variable which points to same object is called shallow cloning. This activity, creating an object and then storing it into the other reference variable so that both reference variables are pointing to the same object, is called shallow cloning. But in general, if someone is talking about cloning, means he is talking about deep cloning. That's all for this video, guys. Don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe my channel on YouTube, like my page on Facebook, and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.